We deal cards one by one from a standard deck of 52 cards without replacement. We stop dealing when either two kings appear or one king and one ace appear, whichever happens first. What is the expected number of cards dealt until we stop? Pause this video and give it a try, and when you're ready, keep watching. To solve this problem, we first consider the ordering of kings and aces. There are 4 kings and 4 aces, and we put them side by side, dealing from the left to the right. How many total arrangements are there? There are 8 slots, and for each slot, you choose a card from the remaining cards. So for the first slot, you have 8 choices. For the second slot, you have 7 choices. For the third slot, you have 6 choices, and so on. So the total number of arrangements is 8 times 7 times 6 and so on, which gives us 8 factorial. However, when two kings swap among themselves, the arrangement remains the same, so we are overcounting. The number of arrangements among the 4 kings is 4 factorial, and the same goes for the aces. So to avoid overcounting, we divide 8 factorial by 4 factorial times 4 factorial, which gives us 70. Let us consider the first and second cards. Case 1, we have 2 kings, and the 6 remaining cards are 4 aces and 2 kings. The total number of arrangements is 6 factorial divided by 4 factorial times 2 factorial, which gives us 15. Case 2, we have 1 ace and then 1 king. There are 6 remaining cards, 3 kings and 3 aces. So the total number of arrangements is 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial times 3 factorial, which gives us 20. For case 3, we have 1 king and then 1 ace. This is actually just the same as case 2, so the total number of arrangements is also 20. Lastly, if we have 2 aces, the number of arrangements is the same as case 1, which is 15. For cases 1, 2, and 3, we can stop dealing. So there are 55 scenarios in which we can stop dealing after we have 2 target cards. But for case 4, we need to continue dealing. Now for the third card, if we have a king, we can stop dealing. The total number of arrangements is 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial times 2 factorial, which gives us 10. And if we have 3 aces in a row, the total number of arrangements is 15 minus 10, which is 5. Finally, let's consider the fourth card. If we have a king, we can stop dealing, and there are 4 arrangements. Otherwise, we have 4 aces in a row, and we have 1 arrangement in this case. Notice that after we get 4 aces, the 5th card must be a king, so we must stop dealing after the 5th card. After getting the table, it's time to consider the distance between the target cards. There are 8 target cards, which means there are 44 non-target cards. There are 9 gaps to fill 44 non-target cards, as shown by the arrows, so the average distance is 44 over 9. On average, we need to deal 44 over 9 plus 1, or 53 over 9 cards until we see a target card. Now back to the table. We can multiply the left column by 53 over 9 to get the expected number of cards dealt. On the right hand side, we divide by 70 to get the probability of each scenario. Finally, the expected number of cards dealt is the sum of all the scenarios weighted by their respective probabilities, which gives us approximately 13.5 cards. Now, as a follow-up question, what is the probability that you stop dealing after exactly 10 cards? Comment your answers below.